This is a basic film tripod, specifically used by Panasonic, as the ones they use on film sets or studios. Now I'm going to show you the basic setup of the tripod. First thing you do is extend the legs. To do that, first unclip these, so the clippers, and then just extend it like so. Then simply just lift up the tripod after. Lift this up, just these bits. And there, lift it to as high as you want it. And then just lock it again, as you do. Next you want to put the camera on the tripod. First you lift up the camera, then open this, then simply just make sure it's actually down, and then just push it in and then close it, make sure it's locked, and then hit the top. Alright, now that you've got your camera onto a tripod, it's time for the basic setup for the camera. First you're going to just put the battery into the camera. Because battery we want is this kind of battery. Make sure it's this way. Not this way, but this way. The right way. Alright, then put it into the camera. Make sure it's up. And then push it down until you hear the click. That's when you know it's in. And when you want to take it out, press that button, which is press, lift it up, and then out. Right, now that you've got your battery, you want to put the SD card in. SD card, you want to use these kind of SD cards. To put it in, lift this up, open it like that, down, and then make sure it's the right way, so it's like that. Then put in, and then click, back, click, and then down. Now that you've got your battery and SD card in, you want to put the lenses in. Now there's three different types of lenses, which I'll get onto much later. But take this one for example, you want to make sure that it's that way and make sure that the red bit is actually seen. Then simply push it there and then you want to twist until you hear a click. And there you go, you've got the lenses on. And if you want to take it out, make sure you see this button there. You see the button there, that button there, as you can see. Silver button, press that and then twist other way and take it out. Now that you've got the cameras out, next thing you need to properly set it up is to change the iOS. To do that, simply that button that's at the front, change it clockwise that way or anti-clockwise depending on the shot you want. Alright, now you've got your iOS, now you want to change the white balance before, and you want to do that before the measuring. Alright, so simply do that, place the AWB button on there, as you can see, and then again press it anti-clockwise or clockwise, just like the iOS, depending on if the image is clear or not. And the person that will tell you that is obviously the camera person and also the director of that shoot. Alright, now that you've got your white balance, as I said before, doing measuring. Measuring one is this type of measure up. And make sure, before, and this is actually done before the shoot, so you know how the camera angle should look, which is where the subject is. And to do that, you want to make sure it's the right way, then put it and then measure it, subject's nose, do that and then change it so iOS and everything is right. Alright, now that you've done the measuring and set up the camera, you want to do the actual shoot. Alright, first thing that happens is that the director would shout loudly, say, "Roll over!" So actors know that it's been recorded. Press the record button. There. That red button, press it. Yeah. As you can see, press that. Then the cameraman would say speed, like really loudly. So then the actors know that to get ready. You know, the shot's being ready, and then the director would shout action. So the actors, and not just the actors, but also the crew, know what to do, that, you know, do their scene. Because make sure when you also do, you know, as a director, the camera person says speed, actually, the director would wait for about 10 seconds and then shout loudly, action. And obviously, like I said, the shoot happens, and then say cut, like really loudly, so the actors and the crew know that the scene is finished, but make sure you wait for about 2 seconds and then the camera person would say cut, then the camera person would say cut and actually press the button. Alright, now that you've done your shooting, you'd want to actually have a look at the footage, and the director would actually say whether that person likes the shot or not, because sometimes the shot's not actually good. So the director would have a look at it. If the person likes it, then they want to either try, sometimes actually if it's good, they'd actually want to reshoot it anyway to try and get either perfect or, you know, again, sometimes it's about quite a few times, reshoot it, or the person want to do it different kind of angles, like close-ups, but it's up to the director, really. And if the person doesn't like it, then the person sometimes, again, like I said, different angles or try a different style, depending on what really works. But like I said, it depends on the director. Now, to have a look at the footage, you press that button, which is mode. Then go to the last footage that you have, last shot that you have, shall I say, in this case that one, press that and then you'll play. And then simply go back, like I said, pause it and then go down, go back, which means you'll go back to the thing, and then do that and then go back to press mode again, and it'll take you back to the camera. And now this camera is professional filmmaking, shall I say. You'll use this specifically, as I stated earlier, the camera, but as I said, in this case, this is used for Panasonic Lumix 45 action. Alright, as I stated earlier, this is the SD card you'll be using, in this case specifically for the Panasonic, you know, don't forget to keep, when you're shooting or out filming, especially when you're outside filming or off location, as it were, you'll need extra SD card, or even, you know, even in studio, you'll need an extra SD card no matter what, just in case one runs out, you have an extra one as a backup, because you're doing, depending on the shots as well, if you're doing quite a lot, then the SD card will run out quickly. So, like I said, have an extra SD card just in case. Same with the battery, but it also, that's something else you have to do as well before the shooting, and when you turn the camera, make sure you actually have a look at the SD card, see if it works or not, because sometimes SD card is already full or has enough space, but again, like I said, as I stated, run out quite quickly. So that's why I suggest have a look at it first. Action. Here are the three camera lenses. They have a Panasonic Lumix 14-42mm Vollinger Nortex 225mm and the Panasonic Lumix 45-200mm. The camera lenses is Panasonic Lumix is for wide lens. The phone tender Nortan is also for medium lens or medium shot. And the final lens Panasonic is used for zoom or close up. Action! Now that you know about the cameras, let's test them out. The first camera lens I'm going to use is a 14-42mm camera lens. I'll just put it on. Now, simply for this, you want to make sure that you get the whole of your subject. For example, like this, and now got the whole of me. Now, my second camera lens I'm going to use is the Vollinger Nortex 25mm lens. Let's put it all back on. Now, for this shot, or this camera lens specifically, you want to make sure that it's actually not on, not, it's close, but it's not too close, so it's like in. Like how this is. Action! Now my third and final lens I'm going to be using is this one, which is already used, as I stated earlier as well about it, which is the Panasonic 14-45mm lens. Let's put it in. Now, as I stated earlier about it, and this one is the third and final one, so specifically, as you should know, is zoom, i.e. the face, because you want to see the whole of the person, just like as we had, because as you've noticed, we're going smaller, 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 or say closer, closer. This one is literally just cut of a face, i.e. for example a dramatic shot or a interview shot to one of the person. Okay, now that you know about the camera and basic setup and what each button does, it's time for a short break, but don't go anywhere, because after this break we will be talking about the camera, about the lighting, and about basic setup. See you guys after the break, back on the camera.